Hello, did everybody enjoy their soup and bread? Everyone is all right?
Yes.
So it's awesome. My name is Julia, and today I will talk about the Thunder, the Drupal edition for professional publishing. So let me first introduce myself and my colleague. So my name is Julia Drupal. I'm an editor. I was an editor the last year when I became community manager at Hubert Burda Media for the project Thunder. So I'm no developer. So please don't ask me any technical questions. For this, I brought my colleague Christian, which is senior developer in the Thunder core team. And he's the one who takes part in developing Thunder and maintaining Thunder. So you can ask me anything about ideas and what we at Burda thought when we started doing Thunder. And actually, that's what my talk today is about. Christian will later talk about what will happen with Thunder later, what's in Thunder 2.0, what will be the next releases. And I will speak about the idea. So what did Burda think when we started using open source technology and when we started developing our own distribution and when we started open sourcing it? And what do we tell other publishers to convince them of the idea? The first question is, why do we need one CMS for like all our brands? So you need to understand that Thunder, the idea for Thunder, evolved from Burda itself. Burda has more than 300 different websites worldwide. And in the past, they were using more than 100 different CMSs. So you see, it's not much sense in this, because local meaning. And this became really difficult as times are changing. And Martin Sorrell, he sums it up quite good, who said, technology will never again change as slowly as it does today. So change becomes faster and faster. And we faced these changes before too. We had the mobile shift, there was Facebook instant articles, there's Google AMP, and a lot more things coming. And these changes are not coming from Burda itself, but from outside. And we had to react to everything. So the idea was to use one CMS for the best case, all brands of Burda, but at least most of them, so we could do development for all brands. So thinking about this, we're thinking, how could we do that? And you see, a proprietary system isn't the best solution. We would have a vendor login sooner or later. We would depend on a company. We could have developed it by our own. And I think there were some tries on that in the past, but it didn't work quite well. So it was quite easy that we would use open source technology. Coming to this point, we have WordPress and we have Drupal, and actually when it comes to professional publishing, this is no question, it's Drupal. So we started this Thunder Drupal project. Actually, it wasn't called Thunder at this time, 2 years ago. It was when Drupal 8 was still in beta, but we had very good experience with Drupal 7. So we gave it a go and chose Drupal 8. And for us, Drupal 8 is the perfect foundation for Thunder. It's weird open source, no way to look at it all. It has a fully responsive front and back end, which is very important for publishing houses. It's built with PHP, it's integrated with V2. It's widely used and highly appreciated. And it's easily adaptable, with thousands of modules. And that's what's very important for us, because actually that's what Thunder. Well, you all know this, because it's a playful way. I did find it out. It's not it, yeah. Anyway. You all know this. What we made at Burda, what our development team made in the past, They took this Drupal core and they added a lot of configurations and a lot of modules which are very specific, are very important for publishers, which are everything they need. So it's not like this. We have the Thunder, we have the Drupal, and we take what we need to get some modules and configuration, and we have the Thunder. Then it was also Playboy, which was the first big one using Drupal 8. It was in September 2015, so you may know this was before Drupal 8 was officially released. Playboy used this Thunder core. They added some new modules. Some of them were very specific, so they didn't get it back, but most they gave back to the core. Then came the InStyle in November 2015. They again used the new Thunder core and added something on their own, and gave something back. And this is what happens in Burda since then. And we realized that this method, every relaunch was faster and saved a lot of time and money. So for Burda, this is a really great thing. Till now, there are 9 German Burda ones running on Thunder. These are Playboy InStyle, Mein Kindergarten, Elf, Hausbazar, Freundin, Bunte, My Life, and Donna. We are waiting for the cooking recipe every day. The other ones are in the middle of the relaunch. There are other ones from the Czech Republic, in Ukraine, and even in India, what I find are already using Thunder. So what do you get from you? Well, what does Thunder look like? This is a plain Thunder installation. Once again, this is what you get out of the box. And as you can see, it looks a bit different than the book. So there's a lot of configurations. We have this is a basic article. And as you can see, we've added some fields for basic information, like the article headline, the SEO title, and some text, and the channel, which is a section where the article runs in. We've added fields for the teaser, so you can add a teaser image and a teaser description, which is the information which is needed for Facebook, and of course for the landing page of your page. We use the paragraph, which is a very small idea, but I will talk about it later, for storytelling. We also added some very important metadata. You can see revisions, it's nothing unusual, but it's set by default that revisions are created. That's very important for publishing houses. It's similar with, you cannot really see it here, but the default setting is save and keep unpublished, which is different from Nuremberg, because that's what usually when you're working in a publishing house, an editor cannot publish an article. So this is a kind of a bit of workflow there in the beginning. We also added meta tags and XML sitemap, scheduling options, so you can schedule your article, things like that. That's the easiest part of it. We're using paragraphs, as I told you, for storytelling. It's a great way to create articles dynamically, because you can add text, galleries, quotes, Instagram cards, and everything. There's a special paragraph for each content type. We can also, as you can see here, we have an extra paragraph for Riddle. This is one of our industry partners, and I will talk about this a bit later. This is what it looks like. We have see your articles, you see the videos, you see the pictures, and you can change the order by just dragging and dropping. And it's a really great way for the, our editors to create articles to do storytelling. I just want to sum up what's the difference between Drupal 8 and Thunder. You see, Drupal 8 is the general purpose CMS, and Thunder, we aim at being the solution for professional publishing. What's really important for us is Thunder, we don't want to be a fork. you don't want to stay very, very close to Drupal. We are using a lot of modules, and when we improve Thunder, this usually is by improving these modules directly in Drupal. Christian, he's working on the media initiative, as you saw in the last talk, maybe. So, we improve Thunder by improving Drupal. We strongly believe in the open source idea of working together with a great community to jointly, you know, think and make things better. But Drupal is not all. There are some functionalities that cannot be provided by Drupal, maybe even shouldn't be provided. And these come from our industry partners. Here are some of them. For example, we have Next TV. They provide the multi-device video player. It's a very powerful tool. Of course, this is a functionality Drupal cannot provide, but which is very important for publishers. So, XTV is one of our industry partners. This is quite a new idea, I think. It's, inviting companies to join, companies who want to earn money to the open source community. But it looks quite good, so what we do is they have to provide a freemium model to these companies. They have to provide very good functionality for free, a functionality which is useful for publishers. So we won't do models like you can try this for 2 months and then you have to pay for it, but you have to do, it has to be for free like forever. So for example, XTV, you have 100,000 video plays per month for free. They help you with monetizing the videos. So we assume that when you are showing more than 100,000 videos per month, you can earn money with it, and it's only fair that you can pay money for it. It's similar with Google. They provide, they provide opinion polls, quizzes, personality tests. And as you see, this video, I chose as a sample, it's a part of the Thunder environment. You have the usual content, schedule and everything, and riddles. And you can create your riddles directly in Thunder, so the developer don't have to leave this environment. Did a little riddle on this Drupal camp. And then you see, this is what it looks like in the backend. So it's very easy to use and to work with this riddle. The developers must be, I think they developed games before, which really a lot of fun to use these videos. And you can use it for free, and there's just the riddle logo somewhere below. If you don't want this, you have to pay. But we think that's a fair deal. So, here's some progress. As Thunder, we can benefit from the different business models of our brands. You see, the player, he earns money with paid content. That's concept, which is my, the cooking recipe. They have a very lively community which writes recipes. My schöner Garten, my beautiful garden, they have a lot of e-commerce. They are selling seeds and things like that. Ubuntu, they have a lot of videos. So, what we realize is when all our brands are running on Thunder and each brand adds what's important for them, we would have a really good CMS in the end. A CMS which probably is okay for almost every publisher in the world. And we realized too that we can be even faster in doing this when we invite other publishers to join the community. Yeah, but it's not that easy to convince publishers of doing open source or even our own books to give away these investments to other publishers or competitors. So, what we tell them is that they have to realize that publishing technology is changing. Let's say the next chapter. In the past, technology was a friend of each publisher. You needed a printing press to print your newspaper and to reach an audience. You also needed logistics, a network. Technology defines the quality of your service. The faster your press and the faster your logistic network, the better you could reach people. In the 80s and 90s of last century, technology became even more important. The printing and the logistics were still very important, and the computers defined how the internal performance was. This was true till 20 years ago, in the 2000s, when the internet came. And then technology was no longer our friend, because now everybody could become a publisher, you and me as well. You can post a YouTube videos, you can post a tweet, and you can reach millions of people. So technology no longer made a difference for publishers. So this was quite a shock for them. It still is, probably. And what we need to realize, or publishers need to realize, is that technology no longer makes a difference. But what still makes a difference is the brand, the mind of the journalists, the content they produce, the connections they have to politicians, to the readers as well, as both directions. So you may realize you visit InStyle because you think they have the best opinion about fashion. They know the best about fashion. They are in Milano or Paris or whatever. So you visit InStyle because they have the coolest CMS ever. And that's what the publishers need to realize, that technology doesn't make a difference, but the content. In some areas, they already have realized this. So open source software is on almost all levels of the publishing technology stack. They're using Linux and operating system, an Apache and web server, and MySQL database. No one thinks about this, but when it comes to CMS, most publishers still rely on proprietary systems or some homemade systems. And the Thunder? We want to be the missing open source component in this chart. But how can we do that? We introduced the Thunder Coalition. The Thunder Coalition is, there's no member form or something like this. The Thunder Coalition is a group of people who try to make Drupal and Thunder better so publishers can use it in a better way. The third step was open sourcing Thunder in the last year. It was still in beta then, and there are not many publishers using it right now, because the just official release was in January or beginning of February this year. But we started talking about it. And we started to explain publishers the following. You can use Thunder for free and unlimited. And this is actually quite hard to explain. People always learn there's nothing for free in this world. And what we come here is for free. So they always ask, we don't believe you. How do you earn money with it? What's your business model? So we have to explain a lot. There's no business model. You don't earn money. You don't get your data. We explain them open source. We explain that everybody together will do this, that everyone gets faster, everyone saves costs. So all the benefits, the bola as well, yes, but only in this way. And we also explain that it's free. You can use it forever. It's under the new public license. And you can decide, it's a very important point for publishers too, you don't have to give back anything if you don't want. Of course, you can use it for yourself and don't give back anything. That's not the idea. But it's open source, you can do whatever you want. But what you hope is that you give back at least some of it, or better all, then you will be happy over the top. There has almost no ads, there will be no sign that Burda is behind this. This is kind of a problem. We have to explain a lot that this is no Burda product, so, unless it kind of is, but we will not collect any data. We cannot even do that. Actually, we could do it without telling anybody. So we are explaining both. We are on one hand explaining you can use it without telling and don't giving anybody. But of course, this would be great because it is the idea. As I told you, we started open sourcing Thunder and talking about it 1 year ago. Till then, we have talked to almost 500 people from 250 companies. These are some of it. Most are interested. So of course, nobody will throw away their old CMS because his Thunder. Nobody would do that. We launch all its cost. But all these companies are interested. All the talks with publishers, I only once heard, I don't believe in the idea of open source. So okay, but only once. Most people at least think about it, and some are coming back now. They now they're looking for new CMS. Some publishers who I talked to in my first week, so almost 1 year ago, now come back and have their requirement catalog and want to check if Thunder suits. So it seems like we hit a nerve. Actually, we didn't know that in the beginning. When we open source Thunder, we didn't know what could happen. So it also could happen that everyone here is stupid who won't want to use that. It's not a good idea. But it went quite well. Actually, quite went so good that publishers also asked, who can help me if I want to do a relaunch on Thunder? That's when we introduced our certified Thunder integrator program. You get this logo, and then you are a certified Thunder integrator. There's no big formal process. Every developer, IT consultancy, agency can become a Thunder integrator. You have to do a Thunder project for this, and we will check it. We will check your code, and we will talk with the customer if he's happy. And if my team is happy, and if your customer is happy, you will be a certified Thunder integrator. That's it. So now we have six TTRs, which are Galani for Object, und Paul, Wunder, Überbit, Sternwald, and Valuebound, who are in India and the United States. The companies on the right side, those are companies who are interested in becoming a certified Thunder integrator or who are already in the middle of the certification process. Okay, so let's sum it up. The Thunder Coalition, with the Thunder Coalition, we want to introduce a culture of sharing and cooperation in the publishing world. Together, as a Thunder Core team who maintains the distribution, the publishers and the CDIs, they work together, and the industry partners who add functionality, we want to build best possible CMS for publishers, and we strongly believe in this idea. So, join today. Spread the word, that's very important for us. We'll talk about it again and again, and so let's change the future. If you want to stay tuned, we have a newsletter on our website, thunder.org, and that will be a lot prettier in the future, I hope. But still, there's a newsletter. We are on Twitter as the Thunder Core team, and we introduced a Slack team, which you find at thunder.org/slack. That's it so far. I see I've been really tricky. So I have time for a little battle. You can win a Raspberry Pi today with Thunder out of the box. Actually, you can win two. We Christian, he's really into Drupal stuff. This new, you can should give Drupal a star, under a star on Drupal.org, and then you tweet about it today till tomorrow, so you have 24 hours, and then you go raffle the winner to under prize. That really is it. Are there any questions about Thunder? Okay. But you have a longer break. Thank you very much.